You guys know the words to the next part. All you gotta say are the words, shut up, all right? And you guys follow Chester on this. You ready? This side, you ready?
Thank you guys very much.
Make some noise for Jay-Z.
Thank y'all for coming out. We appreciate y'all. Everybody make some noise for yourself one time. Sir.
am walking a dark road at night or strolling through the park. When the light begins to change, I sometimes feel a little strange, a little anxious when it's dark. Fear of the dark. Fear of the dark. I have a constant fear that something's always near. Fear of the dark. Fear of the dark. I have a phobia that someone's always there.
Thank you.
walking a dark road. I am a man who walks
sky before me, There's no time to prepare. Salvage a lost horizon, but no regrets from me. Maybe I'll be back some other day to live again, just who can say? In what shape or form that I might be, just another chance for me. A hurried time, no disgrace, instead of racing to conclusion and wishing all my life away. No one can stop me now. Time is up, it couldn't last, but there's more things I'd like to do. I'm coming back to try again. Someday maybe I'll wait till then. No more lies! 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 They're all sitting at my table, talking tall and drinking wine.
space riders with no names. I'll take you to the stars. I'll show you just who we are. We fear none. We've never known another way. From the gun, crosses, and you know you'll pay. Offensive view, no family, we walk alone. Black hole saloon, the wildest place you've ever known. I'll take you to the stars, I'll show you who we are. We're space riders with no name. I'll take you to the stars.
Yeah. All right. Hello, everyone. Hope you guys can hear me loud and clear. First of all, thank you so much for spending your Thursday evening with me. Just a couple of big announcements. I think some of you already know what it is, or you can guess. But after I make this big announcement, I'll be taking some questions from you guys. More than happy to answer any questions that you may have. It's a big announcement lah. Okay, I'll be answering questions from Facebook, from YouTube, and from Instagram Live. Okay, some of you have asked if it's about me migrating, or if it's about me declaring that Bak Kut Teh in Singapore is better than Bak Kut Teh in Malaysia. This one won't happen. Migrating most likely, okay. No, I'll never declare that Singapore food is better than Malaysian food, okay? Just to check, y'all can hear me clearly. Yes, y'all can hear me. IG, YouTube, Facebook, all can hear me, right? Can hear me, eh? All right, cool. So, hold on. Okay. Okay, so here's the announcement, okay? And I want to say a big thank you to all my fans, friends, and people who've been supporting me all these years. I'm very happy to say that I've successfully sold my second special to Netflix. The deal was done some time back, and it's going to be available on Netflix. Once again, the global release worldwide. And it'll be available on the 9th of February this year. Okay, 9th of February this year. It's going to be called Ride with Caution. Sorry, this way. So, Ride with Caution. Okay, Ride with Caution. And for those of you, this, just to give you a big some insights, this was shot from my special Hiti, which was my tour. I'm trying to get the comments from Facebook. Hold on. I can't seem to get the comments from Facebook. 1 minute. There we go. Okay. Yes. So this was shot from my special Hiti. This year I toured Hiti to multiple countries, several cities in KL, Singapore, London, Jakarta, and I took the opportunity to shoot it in Singapore at the Esplanade Theatre. This was the biggest show of my career thus far. So I shot it in Esplanade. Big thanks to all the crew who shot my special, namely the cameraman Kim Hock and my producer Kubeer, and all the crew at Esplanade Theatre. Thank you very much. And of course, all the fans who came out and watched the show. You guys were an amazing audience. So thank you very much. You made the taping a great success. So thanks for coming out, packing out the Esplanade Theatre. That was an amazing experience. You know, thousands of people watching and me performing stand-up comedy. It's a very humbling experience. So once again, thank you to everyone who helped me out producing the show and ultimately making on the world's biggest platform. Some of you who watched the show, you already know what Ride with Caution means. Don't spoil it for others, okay? And also, I want to say a big thank you to Charmaine Othman, because Charmaine actually gave me the title Ride with Caution. I was thinking what to call my special, and she gave me a good idea, which is Ride with Caution. Right? So thank you very much, Charmaine. Also, big thank you to all the Singaporean stand-up comedians who helped me out with the show, namely Jackie Ng, who opened the show for me. If you watch a show in Singapore, the guy who came on first, very, very funny comedian, Jackie Ng. I'm very sure one day he's going to be a superstar on his own. Okay, so at this point, I'm sure you all have some questions ready to answer them regarding this particularly big announcement. It's a big deal for me. And once again, available on the 9th of February on Netflix, on all, wherever Netflix is available, you can watch me. I'm very, very happy. A good start to the new year. And personally, I like the show a lot. You know, this show, I think I performed it about 30 times before we taped it. So, feels good to have a well-polished show on Netflix. So, yeah. Any questions? I'm ready to answer, be it on Instagram, Instagram here, Facebook or YouTube. Okay? Any questions? Kelvin Liu on Facebook asks, can you share... can I share my Netflix password? I cannot, number one, because it's apparently going to be banned soon. And number two, this password, Netflix password, is I share from someone else also. So I can't share that also. Whoops. Okay. Let's see. On YouTube, okay. What happened to the tasting of Singapore Bak Kut Teh? I've actually already done it on Facebook. And it was live on Facebook. Horrible experience. I actually went to a place called... I went to a place that sold the Malaysian version of our Bak Kut Teh. Still horrible. I got so upset that the next week I had to eat Bak Kut Teh in actual Klang in Malaysia to wash off the taste. Yeah. Okay, what else? Red light equals CNY mood. I wasn't thinking about it, but yeah, why not? Kong Hei Fa Choy. Okay, I wanted to match. You can't see it now, but the background of my Netflix special is a bit red, so I wanted to match that. I keep doing this. This. My hand should be here. Okay. Been avidly following you since your free daily show. Wow, thank you very much. Seng Fat. How did you get in contact with Netflix? Did they reach out? Oh, okay, so... I mentioned this before, there are many ways to get in contact with Netflix, of course. For me, I produce the show myself first. By the way, shout out to the production house, Space Lion Studios in Singapore. They did a fantastic job. So for those of you who don't know, the production house is the one who takes the recording, the audio recording, and puts them together, edits them, and makes the colors look nice, mixes the audio so it looks crisp and clear, sounds crisp and clear. So thank you once again to Space Lions Studios in Singapore for doing a fantastic job post-producing this show. Okay, my special was in very good hands from day one. So thank you very much, Space Lions Studios. So what I did was I produced the show myself. And then I said, hey Netflix, do you want this? And then they said yes. And then the deal is done. Okay, but of course, there are many other things like making sure you're ready and making sure the show is good lah. That is a whole other story altogether. But yeah, it's a multi-layered process. Let's see. When are you coming to Singapore for show again? That's a very good question. I will answer it shortly after this. I have a special extra announcement after this. Okay. Are you getting any movie roles soon? Zach Yen, I wish. How much did you sell your show to Netflix? That is private and confidential. But I can safely say not enough money. I sold it for not enough money. Will your work survive the woke crowd, especially on Netflix? This is a very interesting question. I think my work stand on its own. I think it's funny on its own, of course. And the fact that Netflix has agreed to take a chance on this means that, you know, smarter people than me know that it's not gonna get us in trouble, safe to say. The value of stand-up comedy in this today's current woke culture, cancel culture, that's another question for another day. But I perform in markets, in places where woke culture is very much in vogue. For example, I perform outside of Malaysia and they like my stuff, so I'm not too worried on that front. You know, like I said, it's not the intention to, not my intention at all to be offensive, you know. So yeah, I think it'll be okay. So please go and watch it when it's available, 9th of February. Victor, will I be paid as well to be on Netflix since I was there at Esplanade watching your show last year? Thank you, Victor, for coming. Thank you for being a good part of a good crowd. I believe there were signs on the theater saying if you attend the show, you agree and consent to be recorded. So unfortunately, you will not be paid because I cannot afford your appearance fees, especially Singaporean appearance fees. Let's see. Will you change your Netflix thumbnail to actually riding on something? That's a very good question. I was thinking about it and I may have time enough to maybe come up with a poster or something to show that I was riding on something. That's a very good question, Kelvin Liu. Let's see. What are the chances of MACC reuniting for shows? Very low, because all of us now are very busy with our own individual careers. I'm busy with touring. Douglas is busy being a movie star in Malaysia. Chiho is busy being a very good dad and being a show producer for other comedians. And I believe Kwan Jan Han is now a creative director at an ad agency. What I'm trying to say is, of the four MACC comedians, I'm the only one doing stand-up comedy. The rest are doing fucking bullshit. Just kidding, they're still my friends. Okay, we are still friends. So, but unlikely to reunite. Okay? Let's see. Let's see if any questions on Instagram. Hold on. Let's see. Someone says, what if someone Will Smith me? Okay, what he's asking is, what if someone slaps me while I'm on stage doing stand-up comedy? The answer is yes, I will use my jiu-jitsu against them. And I will make them pay for trying to slap me. Okay, that's the reason I do jiu-jitsu. That's the reason why a lot of stand-up comedians do jiu-jitsu now, so self-defense. Okay, but I'd be a bit afraid to do use the jiu-jitsu as self-defense when I perform in countries like America, because no matter how good I am, I cannot armbar a bullet. Would you say yes to Singapore if they invite you to be Singapore citizen? It has been a goal of mine, actually, to move to Singapore one day. To be a citizen, I'm not sure, because although I feel that I can say that I would love to be a Singapore citizen, but the problem is that means I will cease being a Malaysian citizen, and I don't think I'm ready to stop being a Malaysian. So yeah, let's see. What else? You are legendary. Oh my god, Neo Sui Lin, who played Ama in Portugal, just said I'm legendary. That is nonsense. You are the real legend, Sui Lin. Thank you very much. I grew up watching you. Let's see. Joseph, my friend, said, I'm going to cancel you. For those of you who don't know, Joseph is an influencer, filthy influencer on Instagram, and he wears mankinis. So I think it is likely he'll get cancelled first before I do. Do you feel Malaysia is now in good hands under the unity government? Wow, what a mood, what a downer, right? We're having fun here, and then we talk about politics. But I think Malaysia is in better hands than if PAS were to be form the federal government. Yeah. Let's see. Do you plan a Europe tour? Not really. But who knows in the future, right? Some of my comedian friends have performed in Europe, doing pretty well. So why not? I might consider. Let's see. What other questions on Instagram? Okay. If there are no other questions, I'll move on to my big announcement. Well, obviously, you'll be hearing a lot from me in the next couple of weeks leading up to the 9th of February. Last year, I'm sorry, the last time I was on Netflix, my special became the number 4 on the top 10 watch list in Malaysia. And I think number 6 or 8th in Singapore, right? So hopefully this year, I hope to be number 1 most watched list in Malaysia, and number 1 also most watched in Singapore. Let's hope that comes to pass. So I'll be ramping up my efforts to make sure everyone knows that I'm on Netflix. And every one of you watching can also help me. Please tell your friends that you can watch my second Netflix comedy special, Ride With Caution, 9th of February. Okay? Let's see. When are you coming back to Singapore to perform? I will answer that question very, very shortly. When are you coming to Hong Kong? I hope to answer that very shortly too. Okay, Kelvin Liu. Again, this guy is my number one fan lah. Will the Netflix show be PG or R rated? What is the percentage of penis jokes? Percentage. She's asking for percentage of penis jokes. I will... And if any, how much are about yours? Okay, I tell you what, Kelvin, you just watched my Netflix special on the 9th of February. The fact that you're asking me all these questions means you didn't come and watch my live show, the actual show. You don't want to pay tickets to come and watch me. You want to watch me on Netflix for free, okay? Jasmine Mong. Okay, we helped make number one. We'll broadcast for you. Thank you, Jasmine. Thank you very much. Let's see. Okay, I'm going to take a final batch of questions from YouTube, and then I'm going to move on to my next announcement. Now that you... while I still have y'all, okay? Let's see. With your continued success, do you have any plans to grow local talents? Of course, local talents are my friends, you know. This year, I did a show called Dr. Jason Leong and Friends, which is like a gala show where there's like I host and there's like 8 comedians. It's a great success, so I'm going to replicate that for this year. I'm going to tour with my good friends in comedy, and I cannot wait. So I think the show was amazing. We all had good fun. Can't wait to do it again. Will you be collaborating with Ronnie Cheng? I think Ronnie Cheng is too busy collaborating with other people to collaborate with me, but it's always fun to hang out with him when our paths do cross. Okay, he's a good friend, but very busy, very famous. Who is your favorite comedian that inspired you to do stand-up? Well, I first watched Harith when I was 16 or 17 years old at the Actor Studio Bangsa. And I've said this before, my first date with my then girlfriend. Oh, she was not my girlfriend yet, but the first time we went out, she didn't know it was a date. Was to watch Harith Iskandar perform at, I believe, KL Pack. It was an amazing show. Right? And then of course Douglas Lim gave me my big break in comedy. He brought me to tour all around Malaysia and Singapore with the Malaysian Association of Chinese Comedians. So yeah, these two OGs have inspired me to be better comedians. OG doesn't mean original gangster. OG means old gentleman. Okay. Okay. I hope to see you, to help to see stand-up expand beyond Klang Valley. Me too. Okay. So once again, to recap, watch my Netflix special, Ride With Caution, 9th of February, a month from now. You'll be bombarded with a lot of news and information regarding the special. Once again, I hope to make it number one most watched in Malaysia. Number one most watched in Singapore. Okay? Moving on to my second announcement. Now, a lot of people have been asking, when am I touring again? And here it is. Okay? There we go. That is my... new tour for 2023. Just to give a recap, last year was a great year for me doing stand-up because I managed to perform in two new places, London and Jakarta, Indonesia. Shows were sold out. Very, very happy. Oh, I'm so sorry. For those of you on Instagram, you can't see what I've just posted, but basically, it is my poster of my new tour in 2023, okay? It's a very nice poster. I'll post on IG soon, don't worry. So this year will be my biggest tour yet. I'm performing in almost 20 cities, I believe. I'll start off in Penang because Penang is my favorite place to start doing a tour, okay? Penang, and then Melbourne, Brisbane, Sydney, Adelaide, Perth, and Auckland. For the first time, I'm performing in New Zealand. So for those of you who are in Auckland, please tell your friends in Auckland that I'm coming to do stand-up comedy for the very first time in the very beautiful city of Auckland. And after that, I'm going to perform in Kuching once again. Kuching was one of the hottest crowds I performed at last year. The crowd was amazingly hot. So I'm going to return, this time at a bigger venue, hopefully. And for the first time also, I'm performing stand-up comedy in Malacca. Right, I've always wanted to perform stand-up comedy in Malacca. Couldn't really find a good venue to perform stand-up comedy, but this time we have found a venue. It is, it is, I believe, auditorium in a hospital or a teaching hospital. I'm not sure, but the venue looks beautiful. I cannot wait to perform stand-up comedy for the first time in Malacca. I hope you guys come. Usually when we perform for in cities where there is no stand-up comedy, two things can happen. Either nobody comes to the show or everyone comes to the show, because stand-up comedy is a novelty or rarity in that city. So I believe this is probably one of the few full-fledged stand-up comedy shows in Malacca. So I'm coming to you, Malacca. Okay, very, very excited. JB, of course. JB is always a hot place for comedy. And this time, I'm also going to go to Surabaya and then Jakarta. Surabaya was recommended to me by my good friend and fellow comedian and producer, Mo Siddiq. We had a blast in Jakarta, sold out in Jakarta. And he said, why not go to Surabaya also? Because, and this is his own words, Mo Siddiq. He said we should do Surabaya because Surabaya is the second largest city in Indonesia and full of rich Chinese people. So that is my demographic. Rich Chinese people. Good lah. And then I'm going to go back to Hong Kong. Now I'm really excited about Hong Kong because I go to Hong Kong every year. Always a hot crowd. But I've not been to Hong Kong since 3 years. 2020, 2021 and 2022. So I'm dying to go back to Hong Kong. Cannot wait to go back to Hong Kong. We are in the midst of finalizing the venue. But the date has been set. I will, no matter what, I'll perform in Hong Kong on the, I believe, 17th of June, which is a Saturday. So I definitely, or 18th of June, I definitely will be there in Hong Kong this year. Very, very excited. And then London again, this time at a bigger venue, London. And then Singapore, once again, at Esplanade Theatre. And then at Singapore, thus far, Esplanade Theatre in Singapore, they have been my biggest show. Right, close to 2,000 seats per show. Almost sold out last year. I mean, we sold 1,500 seats because we blocked off the not so good seats. And this year, I'm hoping to replicate that. And then finally, I will finish up at the HGH Convention Center in Kuala Lumpur. So this will be my biggest tour, and I hope you guys come. I've been working on a new show since September. I'm very happy to see how it's come about. I'm working on a new 1-hour show to be ready by 18th of March. And along the way, it'll be improved with all your support and all your feedback and all the people that come to the show. So yeah, I'm very excited. So to recap, next year is my Brain Drain World Tour. 5 cities in Malaysia, 5 cities in Australia, Auckland, 2 cities in Indonesia, London, Hong Kong, Singapore, and finally Kuala Lumpur. Also, I'll be adding some dates for Los Angeles, New York, and Toronto. Okay, because I was performing at the Montreal, at the Just for Laughs Festival in Montreal, and I love the Canadian crowds, and I want to go back there again. And I've gotten feedback that Toronto is a good place to do stand-up comedy as an Asian comic. So hoping to go to Toronto. Also a new, London, LA, New York, and Toronto are 3 new cities which I will be putting up my solo show. So I'm very, very excited. Okay, so, once again, I'm ready to take any questions. IG, YouTube, Facebook. And by the way, for Brain Drain, tickets are on sale already for Penang, JB, Malacca, KL, and Singapore, right? These 5 cities, JB, KL, Malacca, Penang, Singapore, are already on sale at jasonleong.my. The other shows will be on sale as we go along. So yeah, super excited. Okay, any questions from IG, Facebook, YouTube, let me know. Have you considered performing at a stadium in Singapore? Actually no, because I don't think I'll ever be big enough to command a crowd at a stadium in Singapore. I don't know how big is the stadium in Singapore. How big? 50,000 people? That is insane. That would never happen. Winnie Leong. Hello, Winnie. My biggest fan. Winnie and the husband, Peter, are my biggest fans in Penang. Winnie, you can go to jasonleong.my to buy tickets, right? Oh, and For KL in Singapore, there's Chinese New Year promos. You can get discounts on tickets if you buy during Chinese New Year, or between now and the end of Chinese New Year. Okay, I'm going through Facebook to answer your questions. Let's see. Wait, hold on. When's your next show around Klang Valley? Once again, 14 and 15 July, KL. That's my biggest KL show. When do you want to get a new suit? Once again, shout out to my friends at Lord's Tailor, Kenny. Kenny is my go-to guy for suits. And actually, the suit you see on my Brain Drain poster and the suit I wore for my Netflix special, they are both the same suit, blue color, from Lord's Tailor. I should be paid a lot of money lah for this endorsement, man. That's, I mean, how, look at the suit. How many people, hundreds of thousands of people, are going to watch and see that suit, you know? Lord's, and it's also mentioned in the credit. So, yeah, I should be paid a lot more money. Right, Kenny? Right? Okay, so, yeah. Let's see. No Perak. Yeah, because Ipoh is quite close to Penang, so no need lah. Come to Penang lah. I'm performing at the Day One Street Penang, so come lah. It's a very nice venue. Stephanie Ho, sorry, want to ask, could you just do stand up in Ipoh? The last time we did stand up in Ipoh, it didn't sell really well, so we are still a bit scared to come to Ipoh. So. You come to Penang lah. It's just 2 hour drive, 1 hour drive. Sell out in Malacca. I hope so, Tan Kim Hock. Let's see. We'll help promote for you in Malacca. Thank you very much. The Hong Kong cab driver ready to tour you. That's right. Ipoh promo might be tricky because in Ipoh, mostly uncles, aunties, apo and akongs. Yeah, like that. Yes, correct. Hong Kong Coliseum, you're trying to find a venue in Hong Kong. My friend Vivek Mambubani has already applied for various venues and I'm confident we'll get a great one. So how much you made last year? The answer is not enough. I made not enough money. Let's see. Any more try first see how shows? This is referring to my work in progress shows. I'm trying to have a couple of more to polish up my material so that I'm ready for the tour. Peter Lim, discount code. Peter, no need to discount. Just go and buy it between now and 6th of February. You get a discount. Kuma, drag queen from Singapore, should do a collab with you. Again, he is too famous to be collaborating with me. So, too busy making money. He won't collab with me lah. Did you pay Kenny for the suit? No, Kenny Low very graciously gave me the suit. So thank you, Kenny. You got good taste in comedians. What are you drinking? Water, Neo Suilin. Okay, from YouTube, let's see. How do you write for a stand-up comedy show? Well, what I do is basically I just list down some ideas, flesh them out, and the most important part is trying it out in front of a live audience. That is the hardest part. So the more stage time I get to practice my jokes, the better the jokes become. So yeah. Wu Ming Xia, buy already July 15th. Thank you very much. That means a lot. Thank you. Need your money. Okay, let's see. IG, got any questions? Any chance to join with Uncle Roger? Again, I love how you all want me to collab with people way more famous and successful than me who no time to collab with me. But Nigel is a good friend, and hopefully when our paths cross, something happens. Right? But other than that, I wish him all the best. I'm sure he's too busy. He's too busy grappling and fighting with Jamie Oliver and being friends with Gordon Ramsay to collab with me. Okay, totally understand. No hurt feelings. Let's see. Anyone else? When are you coming to Amsterdam, Netherlands? Really, it's all about planning and making sure that I have an audience to go to. in the European cities. Love to go to Europe, of course, beautiful continent, but it's all about logistics and also business. Like, I don't want to go over there and lose a bunch of money. Makes no sense, right? Let's see. Come back Singapore. That's right. I'm coming back to Singapore 14th and 15th July. Okay. Kuching. Yes, I'm going to Kuching in May. I can't remember, but I'll be going to Kuching in May, okay? Can I buy you coffee one day? Can. You can buy me coffee many days also. Okay. Are all the materials and jokes the same in all the cities? Okay. To clarify, this tour is a completely new tour, completely new show from what you will see on Netflix. Okay? Yes, it'll be 99% same in all the cities. Okay? I'm not talented enough to change my material every city I go to. Okay? Shout out to my good friend Shakira Marie Christine Pathmaraja. We've been friends since kindergarten. She is a very, very hot Indian woman. And I believe she is single and available. Right, Shakira? That's what you want me to say, right, Shakira? Mm. Good. Why not tour Kota Kinabalu, right? This is a very good question. You know, historically, every time we go and do shows in Kota Kinabalu, we lose money. I mean, KK is a wonderful place. Wonderful people. But every time we go to KK, we lose money. So how lah? How lah, KK people? How? Boleh ba kalau kau? How? How? Go do show there, lose money. I go to Kuching, make money. Go to KK, lose money. How? Someone got any ideas? Let me know, okay? Let's see. Another questions in IG? Alright. Okay. Okay. Just book tickets to see you in Singapore. Thank you very much. For shows in KL and Singapore, there's a discount period from now till the 6th of February, I think. So yeah, you can get tickets then. Are you going to do a movie sometime soon? No. Nobody wants to hire me to do movies. Comedians don't make money. Doctors do. Thanks to your wife for supporting the arts. Neo Swilin. Still so funny after all these years. Thank you. Yes, my wife is supporting the arts. She is a very supportive wife. Any live meet the fans session? Typically after the show, I will meet fans. After the show, take photos with them, shake hands, whatever. And I'm there as long as there are people willing to say hi, take photos and shake hands, right? No problem. I make sure I do that after every show. In Penang, I remember I think I stood there for an hour after the show to shake hands with everyone who came. It felt like everyone came out to shake hands after the show. So yeah, really humbled by it. Thank you very much. Nice to meet fans after the show. Okay, so I believe. Yes, please come to Jakarta again, bro. That's right. I will be coming to Jakarta. Yes, I'm coming to Australia, Sydney. Yes, I will be coming to Sydney, right? So once again, Melbourne, Brisbane, Sydney, Perth, Adelaide. I know I've skipped Adelaide for the past few years. I'm coming back to Adelaide. And for the first time ever, Auckland. Coming to Auckland, New Zealand. Yeah, so that's all. Thank you very much for sticking with me, guys. Really big announcements. Of course, the biggest one is, of course, I will be on Netflix. Brand new show from #Bless. Thank you for supporting me all these years. Available 9th February, global release. Wherever there's Netflix, there will be Dr. Jason Leong with a brand new show called Ride With Caution. Thank you to everyone who bought tickets to come and watch me last year. Your support is greatly appreciated. And speaking about support, this year, I'm touring again in all these cities. I'm saying this for the benefit of people on Instagram. Penang, Melbourne, Sydney, Brisbane, Perth, Adelaide, Auckland, Kuching, Malacca, JB, Hong Kong, London, Surabaya, Jakarta, New York, Toronto, LA, Singapore, and Kuala Lumpur. Tickets will be available at jasonleong.my. Thank you very much, guys. Love y'all. Have a good weekend ahead. And I'll see you at the shows. And hope you enjoy Ride With Caution this February 9th on Netflix. And of course, lastly, thank you to Netflix for giving me another opportunity. Bye-bye.